The Premier has had a major victory, toppling the Labor Party State President after an ultimatum in a bitter public feud.
Josh Murphy joins us now from Macquarie Street. Josh, how important is this for Christina Keneally?
Well, Bill, most importantly, this puts an end to an unnecessary sideshow. This is the last parliamentary sitting period before MPs break over summer ahead of the March state election, and it threatened to overshadow the entire week. But the state Labor Party president, Bernie Riordan, has put an end to his fight with the Premier by announcing that he will resign his position on Friday.
Hello, Christina. Oh, it's an absolute delight.
Christina Keneally introducing herself to world-renowned performer Anthony Warlow. He's part of a star Sydney lineup of summer events. But at the same time, she was saying goodbye to the Labor Party president, Bernie Riordan.
His actions do not demonstrate the leadership and judgment I would expect from someone in that position.
He finally quit as president after a three-day standoff with the Premier over suggestions the union would support non-Labor candidates at the March election.
If the Premier is of the view that I am a hindrance to her re-election, then I will step aside. The campaign to undermine me is hurting us electorally.
That electoral damage, though, already appears to be done. All eyes are now on the Coalition's election win in Victoria and what that means for Labor here.
Poll after poll predicts this will be the last week Christina Keneally performs in the Macquarie Street bear pit as Premier.
No federal government will rip up the COAG agreement, tear it to shreds.
The rise of Speedo-clad Ted Baillieu as leader of Victoria has Barry O'Farrell's team brimming. They just won't be taking his wardrobe tips.
And I don't think you'll see Barry in the Speedos. And as for me, it's board shorts or wetsuit.
Josh Murphy, 10 News.